Now the theorem is, see, if a comma b comma c belongs to real numbers and a is not equal to 0, then this quadratic equation have roots are complex numbers if and only if ax square plus bx plus c and a have the same sign. So these are pro-important, right? In this we'll prove that first we'll consider that for this one roots are imaginary complex numbers, then we'll prove these two have the same sign. In the converse part, we'll take these two have the same sign, then we'll prove for this quadratic equation have complex numbers roots, right? First necessary condition I'm taking. Necessity condition. In this necessity, first what is that we need to consider? Let ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Roots are complex numbers. We know that for the quadratic equation, if the roots are complex numbers, we can write it as b square minus 4ac less than 0, right? So this is a discriminant, right? For this quadratic equation, the roots are complex numbers if b square minus 4ac less than 0. Now if you take minus common, 4ac minus b square becomes greater than 0. Let it be some equation number 1, right? Now consider ax square plus bx plus c. Considering ax square plus bx plus c. Now, take a common becomes x square plus b by a x plus c by a. Right? Now, a of, can write this one as x square plus 2x into b by 2a. 2 cancel, bx by a satisfying. Right? Now, add and subtract b square by 4a square, add and subtract b square by 4a square. So that these three terms, first three terms, it is in the form of a square plus 2ab plus b square. So we can write a plus b whole square. Yes, expand, these three terms will be same. What is the remaining terms? These two terms are the remaining terms. For these two, LCM is what? 4a square. So it becomes minus b square plus 4ac. Right? So this is the expansion of ax square plus bx plus c equal to a into. Clear? It is in the form of a square plus 2ab plus b square. That we written as a plus b whole square. Now next step, this a shift to LHS. It becomes ax square plus bx plus c by a equal to x plus b by 2a whole square plus 4ac minus b square by 4a square. Right? Observe. So this value is equal to sum of two terms. Sum of two terms. Clearly, this sum of two terms clearly greater than or equal to 4ac minus b square by 4a square. If these two is greater than or equal to 4ac minus b square by 4a square, obviously, this is greater than or equal to this one, right? That is, ax square plus bx plus c by a greater than or equal to 4ac minus b square by 4a square. But here we have by the first condition, 4ac minus b square is greater than 0. Means this is greater than 0. This is totally, the value is greater than 0, right? That implies we can say that ax square plus bx plus c by a, total value is greater than 0. There is a fraction of two terms greater than 0. When the fraction is greater than 0, both will have the same signs.